Tom Libous reports to you. Fighting to keep state spending under control. Exploring new options for economic growth and jobs for our communities. Helping our kids succeed by encouraging them to read and stay away from drugs and alcohol. Welcome to Tom Libous Reports to You. I'm Julia Locandy. Today, the Senator and I are going to talk about a new job plan to help the Southern Tier. How are you, Senator?
Fabulous. How are you?
Good.
Good.
Last time you were here, we talked about the mandate relief, cutting the paperwork situation that would help businesses. But yesterday, the Senate passed in their budget proposal a main focus, which was an extensive plan to help businesses develop and retain jobs. And part of that strategy was to reduce the broad-based business taxes. One measure of this legislation the Senate passed would cut the tax rate for local businesses from 6.5 to 5.2. Talk about how much this would save and how many businesses would be impacted.
Well, you're talking about $65 million overall and about, I think, 200,000 businesses. This is a package for small business. This is extremely important to create jobs. Small businesses often get left out of the mix, Julia, and this particular tax cut would help some 200,000 small businesses, and I think it's a good thing, and the business owners that I talk to are just excited about it.
Right. Another idea is to provide a 10% tax credit for hundreds of thousands of small businesses. Tell us who would be eligible for this.
Well, you've got about 800,000 small businesses that would be eligible all across the state. So it's for those little companies, those little small businesses that would have to get involved in, you know, the day-to-day operations with their employees. So 800,000 businesses would be involved, and I think it could save them, we're estimating, $120 million, which is real money.
Right, and that is at least certain things that you have to do to get this tax, and that would be to have at least one employee.
Good point.
Revenue less than $25,000 and file an personal income tax.
Yeah, many small business owners in New York State file their own personal income tax. They take their income and revenue through the company. So this would help many small businesses. This is a great proposal. Everywhere I go in Broome County and Chenango County, small business people are saying, "Tom, you got to help us," and this is what we're doing here. And it's a good plan. We're just hoping that the Assembly will join us with it. We put it in our budget proposal. We moved it forward. Now we need their help.
Right. And another approach would be to lower the energy costs by eliminating the energy tax hike. Explain how that would
work. There's an energy tax hike that, unfortunately, when we lost the majority for 2 years and the New York City Democrats took over, they increased like 500% a tax on energy usage. We want to get rid of that 500% energy tax. Energy is the most expensive for businesses. It's one of the most expensive items that they have to deal with, other than payroll. We want to get rid of that ridiculous tax that was put on by the Senate Democrats from New York City when they were in charge. They're not in charge anymore, so we're going to repeal it.
Right, and that would actually play off of the Recharge New York and the Power for New York that you did last year.
Power for New York, Recharge New York, all of the energy efficient programs that we were put together for small business would be very helpful here. Our goal here is for small businesses to be able to hire people to create job opportunities.
Right, and you are supporting local establishments and trying to help them stay in business and grow jobs, as you said.
It's so important. You know, we often do things for big companies, and recently we did a lot for BAE Systems because of the flood, because we knew we had to keep those 1,400 jobs here in the Southern Tier. We do try to help big companies, but now we have to help the small business owner, the company who employs 2, 3, 50 up to 100 people. That's what this plan is all about, and it's going to save them millions of dollars.
But there's also another really good part of this, which would be to develop a strong workforce. And a lot of that comes from people with a solid background, with a solid college background. So the existing tuition tax credits and deductions have been increased. Why is that so important?
We increase those because it's about the workforce. I'll give a couple examples. You know, we're very lucky, Julia. We have Binghamton University and Broome Community College. Many companies, many folks who have lost their jobs, I should say, have gone to BCC and have gone to Binghamton University and changed their career path. By giving them additional tax deductions and incentives and increasing the opportunities for the business while they're working there, it's very helpful to educating their workforce. So that if you're working for my company and for whatever reason we're going to give you a different skill set, we need to send you to school for that, then there'll be tax credits that would be available. Educating the workforce is critically important.
Right. Let's take a look at how much of an increase this plan the tax deduction would include. Under the plan, the current tax deduction would increase from $10,000 to $13,820, and the maximum credit would increase from $400 to $553.
It's a good incentive, and an educated workforce is critical. And we're very blessed because we have Binghamton University and Broome Community College, two great sources of higher education to help train workers.
Right. To support local projects that create jobs, tell us how freeing up investment capital would be.
Well, it's important. You know, many times local IDAs and local investments or investors, banks and what have you, sometimes are, they have a tough time coming up with capital. TIF increment financing proposal that we have will help to make capital more available for projects throughout all of our communities and pertaining to small business. So it gives them an advantage that they don't have right now.
Yeah, good for budding entrepreneurs.
Budding entrepreneurs, and we're doing more and more of that. Matter of fact, we talked just last week when Harvey Stanger, the president of Binghamton University, was here about a new incubator to create dozens of entrepreneurs in new exciting fields. So that would be helpful to them.
Yeah, it's been a tough few years to find a job. So you want to make sure that small businesses get the support so they can start hiring again. So there's a incentive in here, and it's called Hire New York Incentive Plan, which would give $5,000 for each job that's created, as well as $8,000 if you hire an unemployed worker.
Again, we want the workforce to grow. If you or I or anyone is unemployed, we want to give an incentive up to $8,000 for a company to hire an unemployed worker. We want to take people who are unemployed and put them back in the workforce. This is a great proposal. It's looking forward. It's something that we need to really get going. That's why I'm hoping that the Assembly will join us. As we've passed this entire proposal in the Senate, we hope that they will join us and pass it in the Assembly.
Right, and along the same lines, to help veterans get the respect that they earned when they come back from duty, there is an incentive to hire a veteran, and that would be $10,000.
Hire a vet. Companies will get a tax credit, a $10,000 tax credit. We need to hire our veterans. Our veterans are very, very important to us. And this is just, it goes a long way with rebuilding the workforce. These are men and women who laid their life on the line to defend our country. They've been away from their families. They've been fighting overseas. When they come home, we need to welcome them. We need to help them. This proposal helps them.
I couldn't agree with you more on that. A lot of this comes down really, though, to restructuring the way government works. Tell us what the Senate and the whole government really has been able to do.
Well, last year we kept spending under 2%. One of the pledges I made in my last campaign is that I would fight for a hard spending cap to keep spending under 2%. We did it last year. We did it in our Senate budget just this past week. Spending is under 2%. It's holding the line on government agencies. I mean, it's your money, and it's about time that we've done these spending restrictions. So we're very proud of the fact that we've really held the line on spending. It's been talked about for years, Julia. We're doing it. We did it last year. We're doing it again this year.
Right.
And we're confident that when the governor's budget is approved, that spending will be under 2%.
Right. And really, when the expenditure report came out a few weeks ago, you could really tell the difference in savings with the consolidation and just everything that's been going on.
We're putting state government back on the right path. You know, working with Governor Cuomo. It's been a great journey so far. We're going to continue to work with him to turn this state around, to create job opportunities, to keep spending under control, to do all the right things.
Good. I want to talk to you now about a special group that visited you in Albany. During session the other day, you recognized 4-H students from Broome and Chenango County, and you told them what a difference they make in the communities. Let's listen to that.
They do. Thank you.
To welcome all of our 4-H students who are with us today. Over the next couple of days, folks from the 4-H will be here in the Capitol and visiting a number of the state agencies, and certainly today in the legislative chamber. 4-H is a great opportunity for young men and women, particularly in many of our agricultural communities, that get an opportunity to learn leadership skills and help to be our future leaders. We know that those individuals who participate actively in 4-H over the years have been better students. They graduate with better grades, and certainly they have the potential of becoming some of New York State's finest as we move forward. Head, hands, heart health. Colleagues, I ask you to welcome a number of our 4-H students that are with us today in the gallery.
So they're really good kids. I understand you got to spend some time directly with
great
them
kids.
That day.
Great kids. We were very lucky. We had a couple from, I think, Chenango County, and then we had a corps from Binghamton, and actually the urban corps, the city corps of Binghamton. They're great kids. They're bright kids. They're very astute about state government, and this is where we are meeting. Actually, we met, they had a breakfast, and I went to the breakfast to talk to them about state government, to answer any of the questions that they had. And as I said, a great group of kids, and there's of course the official photo, come to Albany photo that we took with the 4-H kids. This is the group from Binghamton. This is the group from Chenango County. I'm there with Assemblyman Gary Finch, and you know, makes you feel good when you see the quality of these young people. They, Julia, they just are fantastic individuals.
And you can find more about that and the jobs program also on
TomLibous.com.
Yes. So now with the One House budget resolution passed on both houses, what's the next process?
Well, now we go to conference committees. Conference committees are going to start very soon, and we begin taking what the Senate passed and the Assembly passes, and we tie them together and come up with a budget, quite frankly. And we're going to come up with a budget on time. Maybe even a little early if things go well, and that's what our goal is right now. We're deliberating, we're meeting in these sessions, and the goal is to come up with a conference committee a budget that is agreed upon by both houses that we can move forward.
By April 1st.
Before April 1st.
Before April 1st.
These days we don't talk about April 1st. We don't talk about after April 1st. We talk about before April 1st. I'm optimistic we can get there before April 1st.
Very good. You know, it's been nice weather, and when unseasonably nice weather, and I always think about your Buy from the Backyard program, because that's one of my favorite things, is to buy local fruits and vegetables. So you still doing that?
Oh, we're still doing it, and we're getting ready for it. I mean, this season is coming up. You're right. I get excited when the sun comes out. The trees are blossoming, the flowers, some tulips are coming up. They're a little confused right now because it's a little early, but Buy from the Backyard, again, promoting local farmers, buying local produce, local beef, veal, chicken. That's what it's all about. We want people to buy locally, and in my case, we want them to buy first from Broome, Tioga, Chenango farmers, and then from New York State farmers.
Right. Thank you so much for being with us, Senator.
Always good to be with you. Thank you.
Thank you for watching Tom Libous Reports to You. For any additional information, you can log on to the Senator's website, TomLibous.com.